So I guess I did tell you guys we've been having a lot of rain, and this is sort of what we've been dealing with, a lot of flooding. And I'm on my way down to check out the track and see how the track is holding up, because the roads on the way to the track, at least this way that we're going now, are looking pretty average, to say the least. Yeah, well, that's what we're going to check. We're going to see if the speedway and stuff is okay. Obviously, these roads, you can't take a normal car through. And I'm very familiar with these roads. I know how deep it gets. So, yeah, but she's not looking too crash hot at the moment. So we'll head down the track and see what everything's looking like. Fingers crossed it's not too bad down there. All right, went down the track. Everything looks pretty good. Obviously, very soaked, very wet, but after what happened in January, if you guys remember or not, it was pretty hectic in January. I'll chuck a little clip in here of what happened in January. This is my drift park. It's now a jet ski park. I'm about to drop off the gutter. Oh, am I on the road already? I think I'm on the road already. Yeah, I'm chest height. It's ridiculous. I'm walking down the middle of the road. So you can understand why I am very cautious and freak out a little bit when we have a bigger weather event, especially at the moment. It's all very fresh. So yeah, we had a lot of rain, but then looks like it's gonna be all right tomorrow. But this summer coming up, looks like it's gonna be a really wet one. So that is going to be scary moving forward. But anyway, we'll catch you guys tomorrow in this video, because yeah. All right, guys, day two of this video, insane. The rain's gone and it's going to be freaking 30 degrees today. And because it rained, it is humid as can be. But as you've seen by the thumbnail in this video, I'm going to use this opportunity to turn my Falcon over there into a fully fledged discount spec race car. What I mean by discount is it's going to be a lot of grinder, not the kind of grinder you're thinking of, you weirdos, but I'm going to get my grinder out, and I'm going to start making this car light. If you don't have money, light is speed. The lighter the car, the faster you can go, and you know, that sort of what I'm looking for. The faster I can go, the better. So I'm gonna push forward and see if see if I can make this thing way better. All right, first things first, I went and swept the track. Got a bunch of the water off the track so we can do our little repairs after, which I won't necessarily show you guys, but I just had to get it all swept off. Anyway, I went and got some high tensile bolts, which I'm pretty sure will fix the rack in this thing. So the first thing I'm gonna do, before you can turn an AU into a race car, you have to make sure it drives. So to lift this thing up in the air. For those that are worried, my fork does have locks on it. So when it's up, I actually have locks on it. That's what some of the switches on the side are for. I have switches over there that are for the locks. on the foot that holds that up. So don't be stressed on that. It's not going to fall on me. Anyway, I'll lift this thing up, see if we can get these bolts in. If I can get the bolts in, we'll fire up and move her over to a more suitable spot to turn her into a full-blown race car. All right, let's get onto it. First thing that makes a race car is lightweight. So the first thing I'm going to do is rip all the back seats out. Going to take away all the seat belts, anything that weighs anything. I'm going to take these rear door trims off. I'm going to gut these back doors. And then I might move on to the boot, get any unnecessary weight out of there I can get out, and just keep going along with that sort of process. I've gone and bought my grinder down here and another 25 pack, so I've got 26 and a half grinding disc to work with, and then we'll get on to getting this thing temperature, getting its temperature down. So stick with me, this one's gonna be interesting. A bunch of stripping out already, about to get onto some grinder action. The idea, I just want to get every bit of weight out of the back of this car as possible, because I don't need it. I'm not gonna have rear passengers, I don't have to worry about the door as far as it intruding in on anyone. So any extra weight out of the back of this car will make me, you know, I think it's someone's like 1 kilo equals 1 horsepower or something like that. So trying to make an extra maybe 40 horsepower today. I reckon we can pull at least 40 kilos out, so we're gonna try. Right, so that's my gutted window. Obviously no longer has a pillar here. I don't care about the weather. And this is my door, which is extremely light now. I can't even explain. It's not as light as, say, like my carbon fiber door on my S13, but it is like actually ridiculously light. And I think if I took this side intrusion out, obviously it would be lighter again. But that's just a simple, you know, it's a beater. This is how we're going to make it faster. Make it lighter, make it faster, and that's sort of the idea. So we've made this one nice and light. I'm going to leave the front window in it. I don't, geez, there's a lot of weight in that door compared to this door. However, this door will keep me safe like this. And even though I don't care if water goes in the back, I care if water goes in the front. So I'm going to leave the front and the rear. We're going to pull all this weight out of, so gonna go ahead. Look at this pile of stuff already. There's a lot of weight in all this stuff. Like, it's actually kind of heavy. It's all double, a lot of it's double layered and stuff. All this rubber and stuff's all thick and heavy. It's obviously a window there. I'm actually tempted to rip the whole back window out of this car, because I do have a Venetian that I can put in the back of this car that will be lighter than the window, I guess, and probably look cooler. yet to decide if I'm going to do that. Maybe I'll do that in a future one. Let me know in the comments down below, should I boot the back window out of this thing and put Venetians on it just to go hectic light and see how far we can push it. Okay, that's phase one. Super light, like it's actually ridiculous how much lighter the door is. I still need to bring down a specific tool to get all my seat belts and seat belt, whatever they're called, retractable thingy-majigs. Now I'm going to get onto the front of the car and working on the cooling. It's a very professional job. Don't try this. No, you can probably try it at home. Just be really careful. Let's go for it. All right. So my aim is, you guys have seen vented bonnets. This is the free slash beta way of getting a vented bonnet. Basically going to cut straight as possible and then just bend them up and have a fully vented bonnet for the cost of zero. And I know it works. I've actually done it before. Haven't done it on a Falcon before, but I'm confident. I know it'll work. It'll get all that hot air out of the engine bay, cost me nothing, and if I do it right, it won't look too bad. Normally, when I've done this in the past, I've only cut halfway and left meat along here, so it's not so flippy floppy. So what I might do in the future is come down and just put a piece of metal underneath it just to like support the floppiness. But as it stands, I've got the car running right now and it's actually venting. Like, it's doing what a vent needs to do. And the idea of bending it like I have is that the air running over the bonnet will actually suck the hot air out. So I know it'll work. It doesn't look completely terrible considering, you know, when the car's on the track, you're really not gonna notice it that much. You'll be like, yes, some idiot has got a grinder and cut slits in your bonnet. But at the same time, looking at it, it's probably something that will borderline need to be pointed out to you, or you'll have to actually be taking notice of it to see exactly what's going on. I do still have a flat tire on this side, which I need to fix, which I will be fixing tomorrow. I kind of want to take some like some weight out of the boot, but the main thing that's heavy on the boot is the wing, and I don't know, I kind of like it better with the wing on, so the wing's going to stay for now. I think, like I said, I need to bring tools down to get the belts and stuff out. Keeping the stereo in it because race car. I actually haven't looked if this has all the aircon stuff in the front of it. If it has that, that'll be stage two or three of making this thing a race car, cheap race car. Honestly, guys, there's a massive amount of stuff that I've pulled out of this car already that is going to make it function. Let's turn it off. It's going to make it work so much better. It's a massive, massive difference in an AU between a full weight one and one that's been lightened. When Rudnick was here, he was driving the AU House AU, which basically fully stripped out, everything cut out of it, and then even all the boot floor has been cut out of it and a fuel cell fitted. That'll be something for us to do in the future. Right now, we need to run this thing with a full tank, otherwise it fuel surges, so that's a problem. So in the future, we're going to go for like a 30 litre fuel cell, or even a 20 litre fuel cell, nice small fuel cell in the back, cut a heap of the excess metal out of the back and get this thing even lighter. And if you can think of any of your cheap race car ideas, I definitely want to hear it in the comments down below. Comments are not only cool to read. If you've commented on my videos, you'll see that I like and I'll love heart everyone that I've read. And I pretty much read every single comment that I see. So the little like and little love heart that I put in is just to let you guys know that I have read it, and just to show my appreciation, I guess. So yeah, this is a discount race car V1 We'll come back. We're gonna give this thing a rip tomorrow night with probably Thea in the car. I'm gonna chuck some other people in this car to have a go as well. But you know, the main thing is super cheap, super affordable. The lighter it is, the less fuel it uses, the less tires it uses, the more power it'll feel like it's got, like that it's got, the more power it'll feel like it's got, is what I was trying to say. And overall, I feel it, they're a lot more fun when they're light. Cars in general, when they're light, are more fun. That's why I'm absolutely pretty excited to get the 370 back on track, because it's going to be a lot lighter now and you're going to be able to send the crap out of it. But anyway, I'm going to wrap this one up here. Check out the store, lukefink.com. We are closing the store on the 26th. On the 26th, we're also going to be drawing the Powertune Dash giveaway. Every $50 you spend in store gets you in the running to win, as well as a any of my Corvette merch gives you extra spots in the draw. So check it out. Thanks heaps for watching this one, guys. See you guys in the next one. Peace out. Bye.